Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome to another episode of How We Fix Some Shit. So today we got a Carrier Supra 760, and we got called out because first it wasn't running, but it was a blown fuse on the run stop solenoid. So it needed a run stop solenoid. Went ahead and took care of that. Now it's got another blown fuse, and we checked it, and it's one of the condenser fans. All right, or excuse me, evaporator fans. Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome to another episode of the Shit Show. Today we're gonna fix a Carrier Supra 760. So what's going on with this thing is it's got a fuse blown in it, and it keeps alarming for that. So when I checked the panel, I found that it was a evaporator fan fuse that was blown on it. So I came in here, and the first thing I did was I left it running, and I checked all the fans, and this one right over here on this side wasn't turning. All right, it's not froze up, so usually the motor goes out in it. So we're gonna replace that, and I'm gonna show you how to do that. First and foremost, there's two 10 millimeter bolts right here. All right, and you're gonna take those out. I've already started loosening those. All you're gonna need is a 10 millimeter for this thing the entire job. Of course, the fan and a fuse. The cover on the outside of the unit, it is 10 millimeter bolts as well. So you pull that, open that up, take those two bolts out, and then you'll be able to access the control panel on it, which has your fuse and relay blocks in it. So now that we got to go ahead and got this lower shield down, if you kind of, I don't know if you can see really good, but if you look up in here, the fans right here kind of have a lighting issue, but there's four bolts on the outside of it. They're 10 millimeter. And it's got a, they're threaded into the actual casing itself. So you're just going to pull those four bolts out and then unplug the fan itself and it'll come out. So I'm going to go ahead and get this thing out of here, and then, we'll catch back up on the video. All right, guys, as you can see, we went ahead and got our old fan out. I do have a new one that's an exact replacement. All right, something I want to go over is the different sizes in these units. As we said, this one is a Supra 760. All right. But on the 850s and 960s and stuff of that nature, when you get on up there, the actual fan itself, the plastic in the housing is bigger, all right? But it is the same motor. So a lot of times you can't get, you know, the exact fan because they won't have it in stock. But buying the smaller fan will work. Like I said, the only difference is the housing. If you pull out these four nuts right here, they're Phillips head screws. All right, and then on this side, it's got a little C-clip, a little retainer clip. You can pop that off, pull the fan off, pull the motor out, and swap it to the actual fan that you have, and just do vice versa with the old fan that you have and swap the motors out, and it will work. So I suggest if you're running into that issue, just build your own fan, and you'll be good to go. They're all Spal slim fans, so they work, and it's good to go. But fortunately enough, we have an exact replacement, so we're gonna go ahead and put that in. Remember, four bolts are all that holds it in. Get you a zip tie and zip tie your harness up, and then we'll replace the fuse, and I'll show you exactly where that's at. And I'm also gonna list the diagram of that fuse panel of you know, what's in there, so you can determine what's blown and what you need to fix. We're gonna go ahead and get this back in and get it running. All right, guys, we got the fuse replaced inside the side box. I'm gonna give you a rundown of that and exactly what I did. I'm also going to list at the end of this video the fuse box diagram, so that way you'll be able to determine which fuse is blown and what's going on. But if you look at your controller right here, whenever it does alarm, it'll throw the red light and it'll beep really loud, and it'll say fuse bad. If that's what's going on with it, any one of these fuses will blow, and if it blows, it's going to determine what's amping out and shorting that fuse, you know. So you could have run stop solenoids, you know, the whole nine yards, and of course the fans, anything that sends power back and will amp out, will cause this thing to blow a fuse. So when it does, you'll be able to determine what the problem is and fix it from there. Over here on my truck, I have an actual extra fuse panel and a microprocessor, so I'm going to show you those. All right, guys, this is the actual fuse panel in the back side of the cabinet. So when you're looking at this, you know, it's self-explanatory. It says on the actual board F6, F7, F10. So when I show you this diagram, it's going to show you the exact same setup along with what they mean.
The fuse that we replaced is this one right here. These should all be 30 amp. I pulled this one out of a spare unit. So somebody obviously changed this with something that it shouldn't be. But these three fuses right here control your actual evaporator fans. So I replaced this one right here, as I said, and everything's working properly. But this is what the actual fuse board in the back looks like. Again, at the end of the video, I'll show you the diagram of what controls everything. Over here, we have the actual microprocessor. So whenever you open up the door, this is going to be it on the outside. Your cable that hooks to your computer screen inside the truck hooks in right here, and the actual rest hooks in right here. You want to be very careful with this and not get this thing wet at all when you open that door. So if it's raining, you probably don't want to open the door. But this controls the whole unit. These do go bad. That's why I carry an extra one with me. I pulled this one out of a spare unit that was junk. Yep, that's basically it. And check out the diagram. And any questions that you have on these units, don't be afraid to reach out and give me a call. Make sure you like and subscribe to the channel. Thanks, guys.